Good afternoon. So we don't have a ton of time. We're going to get right into it. We are not going to talk about Cardi B, but we are going to talk about the blockchain. So I am here with Marie Week, who is the general manager of blockchain at IBM. She has been there for more than 30 years. Yep. She did not tell me how many more, and I don't think we should
ask.
We're
not counting that high.
She is also on the board of Daimler Automotive Group, and she, I think, is the new chair of the board of the Anita Borg Institute, which, if you're a woman working in tech, you know is an incredibly important body. And we wanted to have this conversation because it's my thought that very little will change leadership and the rules more than technology, particularly tech like blockchain and AI. So just to do a little table setting for the room, I want you to give us the shortest primer that you possibly can on what blockchain is and why everyone here should give a damn.
Sure. Obviously very misunderstood between cryptocurrencies and Bitcoin and blockchain, but the underpinning technology we're really excited about because it changes the paradigm for how people do collaborate and how businesses can interact. And I haven't seen this much excitement about a new technology since the early days of the internet. And the internet changed how we communicate. This will change how we collaborate and how business processes happen between companies, because there's a shared database under the covers where everybody sees the same information at the same time. When you think about the internet, it's a point-to-point communication system. Even if you're with your social media network or your marketplace, you're operating through a middleman. And by definition, blockchain is breaking those central points and allowing more people to collaborate more freely. And we think that's pretty profound.
So let me pick up on that and say we're talking a lot about breaking sort of long-held norms. Mm-hmm. You just basically described decentralized technology, a decentralized system, which essentially, I think, calls into question things like competition and hierarchy. Are those where the big lessons are for leaders?
I mean, we've been doing work with blockchain in all sorts of industries. Healthcare, education, global trade digitization, securing a healthier, safer food supply. And we're working with really big companies like Walmart and Maersk and others, but the only time you see value is when they get their competitors on that same network. And that has some fundamental issues. You know, the Edelman Trust scores last year was at the all-time low in the United States, that there is this implicit distrust of enterprises. If you now can get different industry players to all come together on a common model, common smart contracts is the technology, to actually enable kind of an operating system of trust between these parties with common governance and open standards, you really can change what people are doing, and that extends to the consumer. You now know, you know, we sold in the United States more organic food last year than was produced.
That's
well,
amazing.
Do you really know where that food came from and what the sustainability was of it and how was it sourced and where did it go through its supply chain? If you can now see that directly as a consumer and as a supply chain, that can also fundamentally reinforce some of the values we've talked about here that you want to see and prove throughout.
Yeah, so you've just described sort of a changing ecosystem in business where company that was once your competitor, you now have to work with. Let's talk about how that works inside a company and how blockchain and other technologies like it are changing the way we think about sort of leadership broadly. So you and I were talking at the Times, we spent a lot of time thinking about how do we break down functional silos and get people to work together. And in many ways, sort of lateral or side to side leadership matters much more now than top down or managing your boss. Is that, how do you see that sort of playing out or hastening?
I mean, I think it's the same fundamental model. All of our business processes are linear today. You know, you pass things from one to the next in a supply chain, in a transaction. What blockchain is doing is folding those on themselves so that you can transform that. But it's the same thing we're seeing in terms of the participants that are operating. It is becoming a gig economy where you get the best skills and the best data and the best information you can for whatever process you are trying to address. And that really requires you to fundamentally focus on what data do you want and who has the best skill and capability. It's independent of where you are in the hierarchy. It really is driving a notion of peer-to-peer collaboration, and that upsets some folks, you know, in terms of what's the governance model, what's the data privacy model. You know, we have said AI changes all jobs. Blockchain changes all processes. How do you now come to grips with that in your systems? And it's not going to be command and control. It's going to be who can leverage the information to make the best decisions when you can, right on the spot.
Yeah, we heard a lot. We've actually heard a lot across the day about collaboration and particularly women and more equal workplaces bringing collaboration sort of into the mix better, better than we've had it in the past. Give me a sense, how does this sort of change the picture of what we're looking for in leaders? And I'll say, everyone in this room, my guess is most people do not come from day-to-day leading engineers or data scientists, but everyone in this room is essentially now in some form of a tech leadership job. So how should we all be thinking about leading differently?
I think that's probably the most fundamental. Forget which technology anyone is talking about. You know, I'm wearing my Dick Tracy watch. I have a supercomputer in my pocket with my cell phone. Every business is digitizing. Every business is a tech business. Every role is going to be transformed by technology. And I had a partner talk to me about, you know, trying to learn about new skills in blockchain, and they said, you know, when I think about it, I can't read about getting fit. You know, if you're really going to get fit, you can't read about it, you have to do it. You have to jump into the deep end of the pool. It's the same with technology, and any user is a tech user. You know from what actually gives you benefit, but you have to try it. Even if that means, you know, having a reverse mentoring relationship with a millennial who is using it every day, mm-hmm. you have to try it, you have to pilot it, you have to see how it changes the background of your own businesses, or someone else will.
So you just gave me a perfect segue to, you have to kind of be in it to understand it. You are in a scenario where you are now working for a CEO who is a woman. Mm-hmm. She has, so you're in it with a woman CEO. She's been there for more than half a dozen years. So she's not new to the role. How, you know, has that been different? And if so, how?
I mean, she has a great saying that comfort and change don't coexist. That if you are comfortable, you know, I had another mentor that said, you're either going up or you're going down in your career. You can never get to a perfect place because someone else will be running faster. So if you're not actually out there trying to make change, you are falling behind. And our culture has fortunately in IBM always been one that valued diversity. So I don't see a change in the support for diversity, but I actually have an entire female management chain. My SVP is a woman, my CEO is a woman, my head of products is a woman, my head of development is a woman. And we're seeing a lot of that kind of notion of the women of blockchain. And I think the virtue of it being a collaborative technology is actually extending to who is interested in participating. And just making sure that people are feeling bold enough to try is the most important part.
That's amazing. I mean, that's a takeaway for everybody, the women of blockchain, that there's a space in tech where we're beginning to see women maybe even play, you know, be more present than men. Let me ask you one more question, and this has been sort of in the ether in many of our discussions across the last day. Will all this tech transformation, blockchain, AI, the digital disruption of everything, be better for women? Will it be better for equality or not?
I personally think so. I probably wouldn't have had this career if I didn't, but it is equalizing access to information, to processes. It is making them cheaper and easier for different participants to engage. And to me, anything that equalizes access, by definition, is going to make the diversity of thought, you know, getting that kind of Medici effect in place there. So, but it's not going to make a difference if people don't use it. If you don't embrace that as a fundamental change and keep learning new things, then I think you actually get left behind. And it's not like I learned blockchain in school. It didn't exist. There are always new paradigms. You just have to get out there and try them.
So digital disruption will be good for equality as long as the inputs and the leadership sort of around it, see to it that that happens. That is a perfect way to end. I am meant to tell you all that we are about to break for 20 minutes. I think there are refreshments outside.